I know that your town, your roots and your family have played a great role in your life. You were born in Gdańsk in 1957.
Yeah, it's true. And Gdańsk is really unique, not only for me, I think, but for the whole history of Europe, of region, of Poland, because, you know, you can find still today influences of many cultures, religions, languages, Polish culture, German, Swedish, Jewish, Scottish, and of course Kashubian. In fact, I am Kashubian also, not only a citizen of Gdańsk, but also Kashubian. It means, you know, that I am part of the ethnic minority. It's about 300,000 people with their own language, with their own customs, very traditional, very loyal to their tradition, to religion. And if you want to know everything about Europe, you can learn something about Gdańsk, and it would be enough, I think. My four identities, because I am from Gdańsk, because I am a Kashubian, I am a Pole. It's my main identity, of course, and I am a European. Yeah, this is what I'm very proud of, you know, because it's this is a foundation of this modern thinking and modern feeling about Europe.
And your parents?
Yeah, my parents. You know, my father was a carpenter. He died when I was 14. He was a very strict father and strong person, if you know what I mean. And my mother was pure goodness and pure love. She was a really beautiful woman. Simple, but very wise, and of course she worked very hard to support me and my sister after my father died. My older sister took care that I didn't become a hooligan, you know, because in fact I spent my whole life in this time on the streets and among hooligans, football fans. Yeah, no, we lived in poverty, but in a happy and loving family.
As I know, history, in particular the history of ancient Greece, is your real passion.
Yeah, it's true, but history around me was much more interesting than books. It was in 1970 when bloody riots erupted right under my windows. It was a huge protest against communist regime. Thousands of people took to the streets. I saw policemen shooting at workers. Dozens were killed. I saw public buildings on fire, tanks, blood. And from the very beginning, it was clear for me. Even though I was, you know, a teenager, who is on the right side and who is on the wrong side. And from this time, you know, still today, I know that people who are beaten are much more often right than people who beat them.